This very short video lecture introduces the runoff coefficient, runoff being the discharge from a stream. Similar to precipitation depth and evaporation, the discharge volume of a river may be presented as a length unit, for instance, millimetre. Discharge volumes in cubic metre can simply be converted to metre by dividing by the total drainage basin area in square metre. Multiplying this result by 1000 millimeter per meter, of course, delivers an answer in millimeter. One should divide by the total drainage area, irrespective of the fact whether all or only part of the drainage basin actually contributes to the discharge. This is because the same total drainage basin area is involved when translating precipitation or evaporation from volume units to length units or vice versa. Importantly, thus, a discharge presented, for instance, in millimeter per hour is not a velocity, what it may seem at the first glance. But a discharge in cubic meter per hour, adjusted for the drainage basin area by dividing by the total drainage basin area in square meter and multiplying by 1000 millimeter per meter. The runoff coefficient of a stream can simply be determined by dividing the discharge volume in millimeter by the received precipitation volume or precipitation depth in millimeter and then multiplying by 100 to convert from fraction to percentage. The term runoff and runoff coefficient should be taken as the discharge of a stream. Another use of the term runoff is as a synonym for overland flow. Please note, the runoff coefficient on an annual basis is defined as the total discharge volume in millimeter or cubic meter as a percentage of the precipitation volume in millimeter or cubic meter on an annual basis, whereas the runoff coefficient on a storm basis is defined as only the quick flow volume in millimeter or cubic meter as a percentage of the precipitation volume in millimeter or cubic meter on a storm basis. Usually, in plots of storm hydrographs, discharge and precipitation are presented using different units. For instance, cubic meter per second for discharge versus millimeter per hour for precipitation, and thus along differently scaled axes. The first impression of such figures may be that a large percentage of precipitation is discharged as quick flow during storms, which may be misleading. As often, runoff coefficients on a storm basis may be surprisingly low, as interception and evaporation losses and storages at the surface and in the subsurface can be quite high. However, in situations when a small clayey drainage basin is pre-wetted by earlier precipitation, or when rain falls on a sealed surface or on a frozen soil, or when snow melts, storms with a high runoff coefficient may occur. To get the perception right, the figure to the left shows a hydrograph of the quick flow for a storm with a runoff coefficient of 30% with, just for once, precipitation and quick flow presented in millimeter per hour, thus along equally scaled axes.